Today, I want to talk about a script which Edward Kmet wrote and to explore how it's implemented, because it uses many advanced Haskell features and I learned a lot reading it, and I want to share what I've learned with you. So even though it's only a short script, about 200 lines, I think it will take me several videos to explain it all. And so today, I only want to talk about the purpose of the script and not looking at the code itself. So the script is called strongly typed bound, and it's a strongly typed version of the bound library, which Edward Kmet also wrote. So what is the ordinary bound library about? Well, it's a library which helps you manipulate variables inside of a representation of some language, here, the Lambda Calculus. And so we would represent the terms of the Lambda Calculus using some Haskell data type. And, well, a very common and well-researched problem is how do we represent variables? And there is a number of different solutions which have different limitations, and some of them are more convenient than others. And bound is one which, in my opinion, strikes a very good balance between convenience and flexibility, because it allows you to alternate between two representations, one for bound variables, which are represented by Dobrugin indices, basically integers, and the free variables, which are represented in a more free manner using, for example, strings or whatever the representation which you need for your program. And bound allows you to make sure that your terms are well scoped. You could not accidentally write a term such as lambda x y, because y is out of scope. And the strongly typed version also prevents you from writing ill-typed terms, such as unit applied to unit, because unit is not a function. So, I want to review how the typing rules for the Lambda calculus is typically given, because I want to point out that the typing rules, they give both the scoping rules and the typing rules. And this will give us insight into why we want a strongly typed version of bound. So, the Lambda calculus, the typing rules for the Lambda calculus, it gives the typing rules, like unit has type unit, and variables have whichever type they are assigned in their context. I'm sure you know this already, but the context is a list of pairs of variables and their type. And the interesting case, function abstraction, if we augment the context with a variable x, with the type of the parameter, then if the body can now be well typed as having the type of the return value, then lambda xe is well typed and it has the type t1 arrow t2. So here, when we extended the context, not only are we saying that inside of the body x as type t1, but we're also saying that inside of the body x is available and therefore using it is allowed because it's in scope. If I wanted, I could modify those rules to define a different judgment instead of saying that such and such expression has this particular type. Instead, I could have a different judgment which says that such and such expression is well scoped. So what would this look like? Well, I can remove all of the types everywhere. So now my context, instead of being a pair of a variable and its type, it's just a list of variable names. And now my judgment is saying that in this context, E is well scoped. And if the body E is well scoped in a context which is augmented with the x variable, then lambda xe is well scoped in the context without the X variable. So this allows us to do things like distinguish between recursive and non-recursive let statements. If I was to add a let statement, to my language, then I would need to give it some typing rules, but now I want to focus on the scoping rules. So I would say something like, if in the context augmented with x, the body e2 is well scoped, and something about the argument, then in the context which is not augmented with x, my let statement that x E1 and E2 is also what's called. And now the condition that we would give to the value we assign to x would vary depending on whether we want our language to have recursive lets or non-recursive lets. So the other condition would be either that in the non-augmented context, gamma E1 is what's called. Or, if we wanted to have the language that is recursive, then we would say, in the context augmented by x, that E1 is well scoped. So those are the scoping rules, and with the bound library, we can define those scoping rules, so that you can only construct terms which are well scoped. And now what we would like to do is to have a strongly typed version of the bound library, which also allows us to make sure that our terms are well typed. That is to recover the typing rules that I had written before I erased all the types and replaced them with scoping judgment. So that was my first video in which we saw why we might be interested in a strongly typed version of the bound library, but we didn't really see what the bound library did for us. And so, in the next video, I plan to compare how using the ordinary bound library and using the strongly typed bound library differ. See you next time, fellow Haskellers!